Everybody wants their AI agents to understand that code bases fully, but as you work on your code and it gets more complex, you make many changes, most code agents will completely lose their way. In this video, I'm going to solve that problem for you by showing you how you can create a workflow that will keep your AI code agents always up to date with the latest version of your code base, which ensures that they actually know what they're doing and will continue to make you more productive. So keep watching this video and you'll learn how to do this like a real senior engineer. To prove that this works, I'm going to be implementing this workflow from scratch in one of my own repositories. This is the repository that I use for my own personal blog. And in this repository, I've created a Claude markdown file. Now, Claude always looks at this when we're programming together, but the thing is, these markdown files contain potentially outdated information about the repository. For example, if we check out where it actually knows how to store the blocks, you'll see here that the blog posts seem to be located in source content blog. Now, let's check out if that's actually true. Source content blog. Yes, it is. The problem is, this can change over time. Let's say that I, or a different engineer, changes this folder name for whatever reason into something like AI engineer blog. At this point, the folder reference will actually be completely different than what is in the Claude markdown file. And if you don't ask Claude to check up on whether the markdown file here is still relevant or not, this is going to be super confusing. Go ahead and ask Claude right now, where are blocks saved in this repo? And this is a super simple example. This is not a complex repository at all. You will see that it will say that blog posts are saved in the source content blog directory. And it thinks that because that is the information that's in this outdated Claude markdown file, even though I just renamed this folder and Claude is not aware of that. And this is already such a simple change. I only changed the name of a folder. Can you imagine how bad your AI agent will get once this markdown file completely drifts from the reality of your code base? But today we're going to fix that by creating a GitHub Action workflow that we can actually run on a recurrence or even manually to update the Claude markdown file. And the way that this is going to work is that Claude itself will actually check up on the repository and see if its own markdown file is outdated in any way. So how am I going to approach this? Well, all the relevant documentation and examples that I'll be sharing today will be in a comment or the description down below. But for now, you can just sit back and watch me implement this workflow from scratch. But I'm of course going to be using an AI tool to do that quicker. So I have two documentation pieces that I'll be providing to Claude to help me build this workflow. We actually have a Claude Code action setup guide here. And the important part here is that for this workflow, I want to actually use my Claude Pro account and not an API key, so I don't have to pay extra for this workflow. And then I'm also going to paste in some information on the Anthropic documentation around creating GitHub Actions that are powered by Claude Code. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and copy this entire page. And I can do that by clicking copy page here instead of just selecting the entire web page. This way I don't include a bunch of junk. Then in Visual Studio Code, I'm just going to go ahead and start a new Claude session. And I'm just going to go ahead and paste that documentation. And while that is running, I'm going to also actually copy over the setup guide. So I'm just going to go ahead and open the raw file by clicking on raw. Then I'm just going to go ahead and copy all of that. I'm going to put that into Visual Studio Code as well. And then I'm going to describe what I'm actually trying to achieve here. I want to create a GitHub Actions workflow that on weekly schedule and manual triggers will use Claude Code with my pro subscription to review the code base and rework the claude.md file so that it is fully accurate. The workflow must be carefully constructed and the prompt used for Claude to investigate the code base must be detailed. Therefore, don't rush the implementation, but do it by first creating an extensive to-do list. This is one of the powerful features of Claude Code. You can ask it to create a to-do list, and then it will just actually work out what your request is step by step instead of trying to do everything at once. So let's actually give this a little bit more space so we can see what's going on. And you can see indeed that we have quite a lot of to-dos. So it's first going to check the current Claude markdown to actually understand what the code base is like right now and how it could formulate the prompt in our new workflow. Super nice. Now, while Claude is thinking, I just wanted to let you know that this kind of AI coding workflow is just a tip of the iceberg of what I teach in my AI native engineering community. So if you want to learn how to use AI to accelerate yourself, you should check us out in the link in the description below. Okay, great. It seems I've created the workflow, and at the bottom here, you can see that it wants to test the configuration, but I'm going to skip that for now because we're going to test it manually. Let's actually have a look at the workflow that it created. In my case, I do this in GitHub, but you can probably create workflows in some other CI/CD tools as well. GitHub is just easiest for this example. You can see here that we have this update claude.md YAML file, and then it does a couple of things. So every Monday, this is triggered, but I can also trigger it manually. And then I actually just has one job. It checks out the repository, gets the latest code. It installs some Node.js tools, probably because it needs that for Claude Code, because that's a Node.js based tool. And then it reads the prompt file to understand what it should be doing. And it actually did create this prompt file here, Claude Markdown Review Prompt. Let's actually have a look at that. This is quite a large prompt as well. And the analysis consists of a couple different steps, checking the project overview, analyzing the tech stack, maybe we added some new dependencies or a new database, right? Verification of all of the commands, because maybe we changed the way that the product is built. Checking out the directory structure, which is great. That would actually solve that block change that we covered just a couple of minutes ago. And then, of course, some other steps included here as well. And in my case, this is already based on my existing project, which is created with Astro. In your situation, you know, obviously this file will look pretty different because Claude will first understand your code base to create this kind of review prompt. So this looks good for me. And then if we actually check out the workflow in more detail, you'll see that it will create a new branch, which is important because it's going to actually change that markdown file and it will need to push that code to my GitHub repository, right? And now if we scroll down a little bit, you can see here that indeed we have the pro subscription token that it will use to call Claude Code. And then it will actually paste in the review prompt context with a couple of additional instructions here. Makes sense to me. And then there's a timeout. There's a maximum amount of turns so it doesn't go off the rails and use up all of my pro limits, right? That's good as well. And then what it does in the end is, of course, we assume here that Claude Code creates a modified version of the Claude Markdown file. And then at the very end, you can see here that that change is being added with a commit, and then that is being pushed and a pull request will be created so that I, as the code maintainer, can just double check it and then accept it into the code base. And then together with the new Claude file, every developer that's working on my project will be able to actually use AI coding effectively again, because the Claude file will be completely up to date with the latest changes. So in theory, that sounds quite nice. Let's just go ahead and try out this workflow. I do think this is going to be failing at the beginning because we have not added the secret yet, but let's just go ahead and see if the syntax is even correct in the first place. Now, I am going to actually revert one change here because I don't really care about renaming this block file at the moment. We will actually be renaming this folder at the end to check if the Claude Markdown files update successfully, but for now, it's totally fine if we just leave it as is. And then I'm just going to go ahead and commit all of these workflow related files and say claude.md update workflow. Then I'm going to go ahead and commit that. And let's go ahead and check out what now happens in GitHub. So in GitHub, you can now see that under actions, we have this update Claude documentation workflow, and I'm going to go ahead and run this manually. Now, I do expect that it's going to throw an error, as I said before, because we do not actually have the OAuth token set up yet, but at least we know that the syntax will be correct. So let's go ahead and see how far it gets and then check out where it errors out. Yep, that makes total sense. We did not actually add this token yet. So let's go ahead and ask Claude how we're actually supposed to be creating that token. So what I need to do is I need to run Claude setup token to get my OAuth token. So I'm just going to go ahead and go back into Visual Studio Code and generate that token. In Visual Studio Code, the moment that I paste this and I press enter, it's actually going to open up a new window and I have to authorize the application. And at this point, I will actually see the secret in Visual Studio Code, but of course I don't want to share it with you. So I'll copy it and then I'll be back with you. So just to make sure you understand what I just did in the background, I went to settings, then I went to the action section under my secrets, and then I added that OAuth token under this name. Of course, I couldn't show you that because I don't want you to use my Claude account. But now what we can do is we can go back into the action and trigger it again. And this time it should work because we added the token. After trying it out again, I still get an error related to adding this ID token write permission. So I'm just going to go ahead and edit this workflow manually. And you can see in here that this is a great example where AI code is helping me along the way because it's creating this workflow file for me, but it's not perfect. I'm going to have to fix some things myself. So that's no problem. I'm just going to go ahead and add the permission in here. So now the workflow is running and we're actually getting somewhere. As you can see here, it's going to conduct a comprehensive analysis of the code base. And as we scroll down, you will see that it creates a bunch of to-dos, like reading the current file, analyzing the project, and then seeing if there's any discrepancies, and then rewriting the Claude Markdown file as it finishes up. Now, this is going to take a little while to complete, but actually, I didn't really change anything that it should check for, right? As you might remember, I reverted the change of renaming the block folder. So let's actually go ahead and introduce a small change that we expect it to pick up when we run this workflow. So in Visual Studio Code, as a test, let's see what we want to change here. I think that it could be a challenge to rename this folder, because as you saw in the very beginning, this is already what made Claude Code trip up. So let's go ahead and rename it to AI Engineer Block. I'm going to commit this, and now I expect that the model is actually going to pick up on this change and rewrite the reference in the Claude Markdown file. So here we go. I'm going to say folder name change test, because I want to revert it later on, of course. And then I'm going to push that commit. And then we're actually going to rerun the workflow on that latest change and see if it picks up on it. So now you can see that it's starting to actually update that Claude Markdown document here. Because you can see here at blog post, it says it's actually located in source content AI engineer block, not source content block. So what we're going to do now is wait until it's done and then check out the pull request that it creates. So now it's created a new pull request in a special branch that points to test workflow. And you can see that indeed it was the GitHub Actions bot that created this commit. Now let's scroll down and find the bit that it changed where it now points to correct block folder. Under the content management header, you can now see that blog posts are no longer located in source content blog, but actually located in source content AI engineer blog. Very nice. You can see here that it made that change based on the commit that we created as a test before. Of course, it's changed much more than that, but you will see that as you iterate on this, it will become more stable over time and only include the actual relevant changes that your engineering team made. And you can run this every day, every week, maybe just manually when you think it's necessary, depending on how often you make changes to your code base. So now I am in that special little branch, and I'm going to go ahead and ask the same question I did at the beginning of the video. Where are our blogs saved? And now you will see that without actually checking out the code repository, it will actually immediately respond with saying that they're saved in source content AI engineer blog, which is absolutely correct. So this is really powerful. You can see here how we created this little proof of concept in 15 minutes, but if you iterate on this for a couple of hours, this strategy is ready even for code bases at an enterprise level. If you want to learn more real AI coding strategies like this, then you should definitely check out my AI native engineer community in the link in the description below, and I hope to see you there.